Hey YouTube, it's Demetra. I am here to give you an update on my plastic surgery. As most of you all already know, I had a fleur-de-lis tummy tuck, brachioplasty, also known as a arm lift, and a bra line back lift on April the 22nd of this year. So as of tomorrow, I will be 6 weeks post-op. I have healed very well. Swelling has been my biggest problem, and I did have a little leaking from my incision line on the tummy, the horizontal incision. It was as small as a the size of your pinky fingernail, if not smaller than that. My surgeon said that it was nothing to be concerned about, but I did go see him yesterday so that he could look at me because I was worried that I may have a seroma, and I was having this really strange feeling right between my incision line and my belly button. It was almost as if I was so swollen that I couldn't swell anymore. I felt like I was going to bust. But let me start off by saying that I was on my menstrual cycle this past week. It would be my second cycle since my surgery, but the first cycle I was on 2 days after surgery. So the pain was so intense with the tummy and the back and the arms that I didn't notice, you know, I couldn't notice anything about my menstrual cramps or anything. Well, this time, since my pain has subsided, everything else has kind of gone away, the pain and stuff. I noticed it. So I wasn't sure if it was bloating from my menstrual cycle or if it was from a seroma or regular swelling. And my thighs swell really bad when I am swollen. So anyway, this will be my first time showing you all my scars. I got my tape off a few weeks ago, but I had a couple of bad bouts of swelling. I just wasn't feeling that great, so that's why it's taken me so long to come to you to do my scar reveal. Before I do that, there's a few other things that I wanted to talk to you guys about. And I'm sorry if I keep looking down. I have some notes here so I don't forget anything. Let's see. So today is Thursday, June the 2nd, and I'll be 6 weeks tomorrow, June the 3rd. He has released me to return to work on next week. I work in a factory, so I do some heavy lifting, pushing, pulling, standing for long periods of time on my feet. So it has taken 6 weeks, a full 6 weeks to fully recover and be able to do that, mainly because of my arm lift. Everything else has felt good for the past few weeks. My bra line lift, actually, I never really felt anything like pain. Maybe it's because the tummy and the arms were so prominent at the time, but I never felt anything, so that's a good thing. So he's releasing me to return to work next week, and guys, my stomach is really swollen today, so I didn't really want to make this video, but then I went back to my initial video where I said I'm going to show you the good, the bad, and the ugly. So I am going to show you my scars, and you'll see my bloating and some weight gain. I've picked up about 11 pounds since I've been off. Some of it is from swelling. Before my surgery, I had been on a low-carb way of eating. And since I've had my surgery, I've been eating more carbs, which carbs cause inflammation. So my face will look fuller. I'll be more swollen because of the carbs. When I go back to work, I'm going back to getting on my regular routine with my low carb way of eating. My pain level right now is almost non-existent. Pressure in my tummy, weird sensations, some numbness in some areas, like I might scratch on this side and then feel it on the other side. It's really weird. And that's just where the nerves haven't reconnected and all that stuff. I think I told you already I've gained like 11 pounds in the past month. And I look for that to come off very quickly when I go back to my low carb eating. And I think that I shared with you guys at the beginning that in 2007 I had lat band surgery, and that's where how I lost 143 pounds. And I still have some pounds to lose, but I wanted to go ahead and have surgery because the excess skin was hindering me mentally and physically in some areas in my life. And it's one of the best investments that I ever made is in myself. So I have no regrets. If I had to do it all over again, I would. My current weight is 240 pounds. He removed 14 pounds of excess skin from my body. I was 229 when I came home from the hospital. I was 243 when I, the morning of my surgery. All right. So he did have to move my lat band port when he had my tummy tuck. So when I show you my scars and my incision line and everything, I will show you where he has placed my port, the new placement of my port. Okay, guys, and then I want to talk to you a little bit about skincare. This is what I have been using on my incisions daily, just to kind of get it healed and get the sorry, the vitamin E oil is here. I've been using this, and then I've also been using bio oil, which is good for stretch marks and what else does this say? Uneven skin tone, scars, aging skin, and dehydrated skin. So I've been using both of those right now, just to get, when I as after he took the tape off, that's all I've used so far, which has been the past few weeks, and that has helped the skin to heal and gotten rid of any excess or any scabs and smoothed my skin out and everything. So I wish I had taken pictures when he first took it off so you could see the difference between then and now, but I have seen and noticed some progress. My incisions look really good. This is what he recommended me to use on my scars for scar treatment. It is called ScarGuard. That looks like a little fingernail polish bottle. I haven't even opened this box yet. It just came in the mail yesterday. And so, of course, I haven't used it yet. But I will be updating you guys with how that works. And I had previously bought some of these scar away strips. Haven't used them yet either. But I'm going to. So, with that being said, I'm going to set up so that I can do the big reveal, y'all, and show you what my incision lines are looking like and what I'm looking like without the tape. This is the first time, so I'm excited for you guys to see me. I'll be back in just a minute. Okay, guys, so I'm back, and here I am. You can see probably from the weight gain and some swelling, I am pudgy right here. Right here. Yep. And I'll do a close review as well, but this is me from the front. Arm, and remember, he did the tummy, the back right here, and you'll see my incision lines in a little bit. And my arms. Woo-hoo! All right, so here's the front view. The side. And as you can see, I'm really swollen here right now. And so hopefully that'll go down. And I'm bloated too. Remember, I'm just now probably on the last few days of my cycle. So here's the back. And here's my incision lines go. Who almost can't feel this one. From in the front back here where my hands are. And then here's my left side. Now I'm gonna tell you one thing that I do not like, and I'm gonna show you right while I'm standing right here. Before my tummy tuck, I not used to. My stomach sat on my legs. If you looked at my previous videos, you saw what my pre-op pictures look like. So I didn't think I had big legs, but guess what? I got big ass legs, y'all. So when certain dresses that I put on that are fitted, they go here with my breast, down with a flat tummy, and out forward with these big legs. And so I can't wear a dress unless it's a fit and flare or something like that. It doesn't look right on me. So I have to start trying to shape a dress for my new body shape. But I have found some stuff that is really cute. So I'm still happy. I just got to get used to dressing like this, or dressing for this new body of mine. So anyway, that's from a distance, y'all. And I'm going to be right back with a closer, to be closer for you all to see, my incisions. Okay, guys, I'm back. So here we are with my scar reveal. As you should already know if you watch my other videos, I had the fleur-de-lis tummy tuck. We'll start with my stomach, which is where you're cut here and here, vertically and horizontally. The incision actually starts up here between my breast. So, of course, you can't see it that far, but and it goes all the way down and connects with the horizontal line, which is under my panties. I'll show you in a second. So here, I'll hold this so you all can see. Focus is my incision line. There's my belly button. Some discoloration and stuff, but I'm very pleased with the way my scar is looking so far. I'm very pleased with my belly button. It was so cool. You should have seen me like a kid on Christmas when I got to see my incisions. It's like opening a gift. It was so funny. But hey, I've been, you know, I had surgery in 2007, my lap band surgery. So I've been overweight for a very long time. And so, yeah, this was really exciting for me. Gosh, I'm trying to show you without showing you too much. So my incision is, where is my incision, y'all? I got some stretch marks, so. My incision starts here. Sorry, I'm pulling and stuff. And goes all the way down into, can you see that? Goes all the way around and down really low, so I don't wanna show y'all more than y'all wanna see. So I'm not gonna show the front. But then it starts here and goes on around down into there. So that's my tummy. I don't know if y'all can see that. Sorry. Y'all can see that. And see, I got lots of stretch marks. So I don't know what the camera's showing you, but this is my left side. Like I said, I'm really pudgy right now, but that's temporary. And again here, I'm trying to get in close so you guys can see. Hopefully you can see my incision line, and hopefully it's focused. I'm sorry if it's not. My husband's not here to do the recording for me, so he's at work. So, and then while I'm on my right side, this is my bra line scar. It's right here. I'll just
Hopefully you can see. I'm not sure. What you can see, but I'm sucking at this, y'all. Okay, so where my finger is, if you follow that, you'll see my incision, and it stops. Lord have mercy, where does it stop? Right here. Yeah. So from here, where my finger is, all the way around, and he had to come all the way to the front to get, I mean, that fat roll was like right there. So to get the best contouring of my body, that's what he had to do. And so on the other side, let me fix my drawers, y'all. Here's the front of my, for my brow line lift, and goes on around to the back. And last is my arms, guys. So here's my left arm. I'm gonna pick this camera up to really be able to show you. It's from my elbow on up under to under my armpit. And I can't, let me see, try to lift my arm straight up. Yeah. And this is actually the arm that I have the least range of motion out of. He said no two arms. This is my right arm. But much better range of motion on my right arm. And my surgeon said no two arms are ever alike. You can see where it ends. I hope you can. Let's see here. He said one always bruises more than the other. One always, see here, all the way down and ends right there. This side starts here all the way down and ends right here. And it's really tight up and through here. It was kind of bulging out where I thought maybe he had pulled it too tight, but over time it has loosened up. So I'm really happy about that because I was scared for a minute there. But well, actually, I think I probably have the same range of motion on both arms, but this doesn't give me any problems. You see a little bit of jiggle I still got. This one, it feels tight when I lift that one. But and he said I could start working out to tighten stuff, and I will do that. But if you all looked at my other pictures, like, I'm really pleased, even with the bloating and the swelling, really pleased with how I'm looking. It's just going to get better from here. It takes anywhere from 6 months to a year for all the swelling to subside. And for you to see your true results. So, we ain't finished, y'all. This is just the beginning. I'm only 6 weeks in, so it's definitely gonna get better. And when I go back to work and get more active and get back on my low carb way of eating and get to exercising, these results are gonna be amazing. Just hang out with me and see, all right? This video, as usual, has went on longer than I planned for it to. So thanks again for watching. Thanks for your prayers and support. And I'm so happy that I did this. And if you're thinking about it, I would say start with a consultation. So anyway, if you got any questions for me, drop them below. As always, big shout out to Pretty Brown Eyes, True Jamaican, and My Big is Beautiful. They are my tummy tuck and arm lift girls on YouTube. So until next time, y'all, I love you. God loves you more. Hey, guys. I'm sorry. One thing that I didn't get to address just now was
compression garments. I had promised you, I believe in the last video, that I had some waist trainers and binders and some compression garments on the way, and I would do a video on them when I got them in. So I got them in, and guess what? They didn't fit. So I sent them back, and I've been trying out different things for my arms and for my tummy and things like that to see what works best, especially before I go back to work, because I do work in a factory. So I've got some things laid out here on my bed that I want to show you. First, let me say that besides what my surgeon gave me, I haven't been able to find anything else for my arms. I tried a thing that was for your, I wish I had it here. Do I have it here? Hold on. Okay. So I tried these. These are for my arms. These are compression garments for your knees. Okay. I found them at Walmart and I thought, hey, I think that may work. I tried one on in the store and, then put one on one day, or put them on one day and warm around for several hours, and because the compression was really uneven, it left creases in my arms. Can't really, okay, two hands. I left creases in my arms when I tried to wear that, kind of in the inside of my elbow, so that's a no-go. I won't be wearing that again. All right. So I'm going to show you the compression garment that my surgeon gave me. Now, he did, when I went last week, he did tell me that if I wanted to, I could stop wearing my compression garments. So guess what? I did for a few days. Didn't sleep with it. I mean, for probably 72 hours, maybe three days, I went without my compression garment. And guess what? Swole up. So no, I'm not ready to come out of my compression garments. I was really active, because I had went to a wedding, so I was doing some dancing and stuff, and between that, my menstrual cycle, and not wearing my compression garments, man, I swole up so bad, probably the worst ever, so, to the point where it hurt. So, I'm gonna stick to wearing my compression garments, and for a while, especially with me just now getting back into work and starting to get active again. So if you hold just a second, I'll show you what I'm working with as far as compression garments. Oh, let me say this. The stuff that I ordered, like I said, the waist trainer didn't fit. And I sent that back because when I really got to thinking about it, you know, the waist trainers buckle or zip in the middle. My compression garment, buckles and zips on the side. Because I had the, tummy tuck, the fleur-de-lis, and there's a middle incision, I did not want to, what am I trying to say? I didn't want that pressure right there in the middle where my incision is. So I decided not to go with the waist trainer right now, especially while I'm in the healing process, because I didn't want it to put pressure right there and then that start buckling in or something like that, because I've seen that happen on other tummy tucks. And I don't know if y'all got a really close look at my belly button. I think maybe you did, but I think I really like it. Besides the discoloration, I like the shape of it and stuff. So I just wanted to show you again. Anyway, here goes my compression garments, y'all. Just a second. Okay, guys, so this is what I came home from the hospital in. It's a two-piece. It's the top for the brachioplasty for my arm lift to for the compression on my arms. And then the bottom is for my tummy. And so I was trying to find an alternative to those. But, you know, I've tried several things. And that's probably what I'm going to stick with for the most part. Especially when I need something on my arms as well. I may or may not switch out the bottom sometimes for one of these Spanx-like garments. I got this at my local Kato store. If you have one of those around, and I don't know if you can see the compression, and I'll put these on one day, y'all, but the compression is here and it kind of stops here. There's not as much compression from here on down, but this allows for you to wear your own bra. So you, this goes under your breast here. And then I got this one at Walmart. And this is also Spanx. And it has the compression on the inside, the inner layer. and then the outer is not so tight, but it gives really good compression, and that is what the label looks like. It's Flexis by Maiden Form, and that offers really good compression. So even if I don't wear the bottom of this, because sometimes where this meets this, these two meet at, it, these two here, it's tight on me, right where they meet. So I may wear one of these for my tummy compression with this top so that it's not as tight in that area where these two connect. So anyway, guys, I just wanted to show you what I was doing for my compression garments as well. Thanks for tuning in, and I will see you all next time.
She's just a girl and she's on fire, hotter than a fantasy, lonely like a highway. She's living in a world and it's on fire, filled with catastrophe, but she knows she can fly away.